through yourself, I would like to ask the Honorable Finance Minister, after the withdrawal of regulatory forbearance in 2015, the RBI conducted a detailed asset quality review, and this led to various adverse consequences for the MSME sector. So I would like to know through yourself, sir, when the government is planning to conduct asset quality review again, and what steps they are taking so that the MSME sector is not affected in the future. Thank you.
Sir, during the corona, we took several steps in order that the MSME gets immediate relief, inclusive of changing the definition. And since 2019, there have been several restructuring formulae given to MSME, and that has been conducted by the RBI under the RBI's guidelines. The stress in case of MSME was addressed through the emergency credit guarantee liquidity scheme that we offered, and it saw a great response from the MSMEs themselves. And that scheme is now being expanded to 1.5 lakh crores more. Therefore, what was 3 lakh up to 3 lakh crores given as a security, a guaranteed loan, now has been expanded by another 1.5 lakh crores. So up to 4.5 lakh crores guarantee is being given without security to give further liquidity through term loan or through working capital for the MSMEs.
माननीय सदस्य आप पूछता जाते हैं
यस सर सेकंड क्वेश्चन
जी
सर टू योर सेल्फ आई वुड लाइक टू नो फ्रॉम द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर दैट फॉर इश्यूज वेयर पेमेंट्स आर पेंडिंग फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट बी द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट The MSME or the small people who are doing the government works are asked to pay the GST without actual realization of the money. So this is leading to a serious financial crunch for the companies, and their inability to pay when the payment is pending from the government, and their inability to pay the GST is leading to a lot of penalties and cases. So I would like to know from the Honorable Finance Minister, for instances where payments are pending from the government, is there any proposal from the government where they are exempted from paying the GST? Because if the government himself is not paying the GST and just the billing is done, so I think it is not wise to ask the MSME or the people who have done the government contracts to pay the GST. Thank you, sir.
Sir, honorable member has raised a very important issue, sir. The issue of government dues to the MSMEs is a very critical issue, and the MSME ministry, I remember Honorable Minister Gadkari ji also speaking to me about it with great concern. I have over last year 2020 reviewed it from the point of view of central government and the various departments which owe money to the MSMEs, inclusive of public sector undertakings. We have made sure that the standard as per rule 45 day be not crossed and all dues be paid from the government side for the MSMEs. More importantly, the TReDS platform where these MSMEs payments can be discounted if they are on the platform is very actively encouraged by us. Of course, as regards GST, it is the GST Council which will have to take a response and a call on how they would want the states also to get into this scheme of things, so that MSME and their dues, because when we say government dues, they are not just central government's dues, they are not just central government public sector undertaking dues, they are also dues from state governments and state-owned public sector undertakings. So as far as the central government, we have taken this position that any pending payment will have to be given within 45 days, and I'm personally monitoring it. However, as regards GST payment, the GST Council is the final authority, and it is they who have to take a call.
Ji Madhvi,